Hi, welcome to Ten Cups Golf Center in San Antonio, Texas. I'm Bud Zenswing, here in another of the continuing series of conversations with Ten Cups Man. Tonight's subject is how to maximize the possibilities of success and minimize the probabilities of failure. And we're going to discuss that with Ten Cups Man. And how you doing tonight, TC? How you doing tonight, Bud? Yeah, let's talk minimize and maximize. All right, when I'm talking about maximizing the possibility of success, I'm talking about taking clubs that you can hit with extreme confidence to the golf course and just using those clubs, and minimizing the probability of failure by not hitting clubs you're not confident with. You ought to have some combination of clubs in your bag that will yield up pars on almost any hole you care to measure. Okay, so what you're saying is take only golf clubs you can hit with extreme confidence to the golf course and use some combination of those clubs. Is that what you're saying? That's what I just said, Bud. All right, so for instance, a 600-yard par 5. Suggest a couple of club combinations for us on that, okay? All right, why don't you take a 7-iron and hit it 4 times and then putt it out for a par? 4 sevens and a putt. Well, if I was going to use just one club, I'd take 600 and divide it by 4. That'd leave me 150 yards times 4. That's my 7-iron. So that's 7 irons. That's 4 sevens and a putt. Does that sound right? That's what I just said, Bud. Some other combination of the clubs that you really enjoy, like a 4-iron, 4-iron, 7-iron, pitch and wedge, and a putt for a par. That should work. Okay, well, we've located, I think it's a 600-yard par 5 at a local golf course here, and we're going to set out tomorrow morning to vindicate your theories, and I can't wait for you to see the footage, and I hope you folks will be here when we get back so we can review the footage together and see how it turned out. And thanks for joining us. Okay, TC, we did exactly like you asked. I can't wait for you to see the footage. I can't wait for you folks to see the footage. It's a vindication of your theories, and it was a great learning experience for me, and I hope for you as well. So let's go to the footage now. Okay, we're going to try to do exactly what TC told us to do. We're at a local golf course here. This is a 585-yard par 5. This is close to 600 yards. We're playing from as far back on the box as we can get. And I'm going to hit 4 7-irons and a putt, just like he asked. And then I'm also going to hit a combination of 4 irons, 7 irons, pitching wedges, and a putter to see how that works out as well. Okay, and here we go. I've striped the golf balls. The blue is going to be the 7-iron, and the red is going to be the combination ball so that we can tell them apart. And remember, okay, hit, make your swing. Don't make the cameraman swing. Don't make my swing. Make your swing. We got plenty of time and plenty of club. Okay, that's the 4-iron. Now we'll load up a 7-iron and see how that goes. Or excuse me, I got that backwards. This is the 4. Let's go see how it turned out. Okay, this is the 7-iron off the tee box. It went about 160 yards, but we're just going to stay with this. 4 7-irons and a putt. 4 sevens and a putt. And remember, make your swing. All right, let's move up to the 4-iron. Okay, my second 7-iron. It went about 155 yards. It was hit a little thin, but we're still on plan here. I'm lying 2 from here. This is my third shot with my 7-iron. Remember, make your swing. Now we're going to move on down to my 4-iron. All right, 3 7-irons to within 95 yards of the flag, and we're going to listen to TC and just... I'm going to hit a 7-iron, see how well I can hit a 7-iron, 95 yards. Remember, it's 4 sevens and a putt. Look at that. This is 4 7 irons, and that's 3 4 irons and a pitching wedge. So let's putt them out and see what we got. All right, this is the 4 irons, 3 4 irons and a pitching wedge. Par. Well, Flag, I was wondering if you actually sunk that putt on that 4 7s in a putt. Well, actually, no, TC. I left that putt short by about 5 inches, but I believe I proved my point that a nearly 600-yard par 5 could be successfully negotiated without ever hitting anything over 150 yards, which I believe was the point you were trying to make, wasn't it, TC?
That's what I just said, bud.
I did sink the 4-iron putt, and it was a legitimate par, and I, again, proved your point that you don't have to hit the big dog to put up a decent score in golf. You got to hit it down the middle. It's not how far it goes, it's how straight it goes. And I really appreciate this little bit of insight, TC, and it's been a great help to me. It's been an eye-opening experience for me, and I hope it's been of some informative value to you folks out there, and thanks for joining us here at 10 Cups. TC and I want to thank you for coming, and I hope to see you again next time.